Yo, what's good YouTube? It's your boy Introspective, and this is it, the grand finale of Character Main Stereotypes. We're going to be doing the final row of characters today, and there are some interesting characters. Oh god, I'm just looking at it. Anyways, I'm ready. Are you ready? Good. Let's do this. There's now a shit ton more of you thanks to Kamemushi. But regardless, I've prepared for you all your favorite meal. For the appetizer, a nice lemon garlic shrimp cocktail with a side of lemon. Moving on to the entree, a beautiful lemon chicken topped with fresh lemon zest. And finally for dessert, a stunning lemon cake topped with a delicious lemon pudding. And of course, throughout the meal, I'll be keeping your glass filled with some delicious, fresh-squeezed lemon- You guys like lemons, okay? That's the fucking joke. Here's a fun little drinking game. Take a shot of liquor every time the Sonic main that you're fighting against presses the B button. It's fun because you'll be dead within the first minute. And not having to fight a Sonic main ever again? Well, that's pretty much as fun as it fucking gets. This game should have never been patched. Oh! Oh, thank God this game was patched! Abadongo! I'm assuming you're all Mother 3 fanboys or something. I mean, why else would you take all the verbal abuse from maining such an annoying character? But anyway, Lucas Mains told me in the comments that I should say that they spam Nair more than PK Fire. But the point is that you spam both. So quit trying to make yourselves feel better, kind of like Lucas did after Hinawa died. Yeah, your boy. I bet all you Roy mains are still waiting on Zero to pull him out in tournament like he said he would, huh? But newsflash, Roy's just a bad character. But hey, at least you guys like fighting Little Mac. But you hate fighting any character with Gimp ability. Now Ryu mains are like the ultimate two-sided coin, right? You're either a really good, technically sound, stylish player, or a not good player who takes advantage of focus attack to F-smash. Damn it, how are you supposed to... How the fuck do you do the true Shory... You know what, just do the regular up B. Generally considered one of the most hated groups of players, you Cloud mains just use a really fucking good character. But you never admit that that's the reason why you main him. It's always more along the lines of... Final Fantasy VII is my favorite game, so I main Cloud.
I fucking love this man's ridiculous neutral game.
Cloud is a gaming icon, and I've always wanted him in Smash. That's why I main him.
This up air is fast and disjointed as fuck. I could really take advantage of this.
Cloud's moveset is so nostalgic. I love how Sakurai implemented his limit breaks into Smash 4 gameplay. It's so cool, so I just had to main him.
Damn. Limit cross slash is truly my shit.
No one wanted another Fire Emblem character in the game, not even Korin mains. But we got Korin anyways, and now we have a new wave of foot fetish lovers in Smash. I assume you all reacted like Etika did when he saw the trailer.
Damn it, Conway! Barefoot wife of all day foot jaws, my boy! Let's go!
And don't lie to me. You've all tried Alpha Rad's AFK Korin technique at least once on For Glory.
3, 2, 1, go!
You ready for this?
And a lot of you call Corin corn for whatever reason, so there's that. Yeah. Now, I wasn't going to include the Miis originally, but all four Mii mains on planet Earth would have gotten mad at me, so consider this your inclusion. I don't really know what to say about you guys because I pretend like your character doesn't exist, but I'm assuming it's along the lines of always being salty that you can only use default movesets in the occasional tournament that lets you participate. Now, you random mains are actually respectable as fuck. I consider you gods. Not because it takes skill to play the entire roster consistently or anything, but because you guys don't give a shit about having a signature character alt. And I don't know how you manage that. All I'm saying is I need my pink Zard at all times. So well done. This...
Don't say it.
Game...
Don't you dare fucking say it.
Should have never been...
I'm warning you, introspective, I swear to God. Yes. Yes, it should have, you idiot. God, I initially made her broken in the beginning because of all the dumbass 10-year-olds who ruined the Smash ballot. Had I foresaw that you all would have voted for shit like Shrek and Goku, I would have never have done it in the first place. The pain of fighting pre-patch Bayo is 100 million times smaller than the stress of navigating through millions of Shrek votes looking for actual realistic character suggestions. You know how long I had to stay at work late, reading an ever-ending shitstorm of votes pertaining to anime characters. It was fucking torture that you would never want yourself. So I bypassed all the votes and chose Bayonetta. Given her insane combos in her actual games, she was perfect for inflicting zero to deaths on you bitchy little crybaby fucks. It was the perfect revenge for that bullshit ballot. But you all were such pussies about it that you threatened to quit if she wasn't nerfed. And sadly, your man Daddy Sakurai only makes money when people buy the game. So I nerfed her for the sake of counting fat ass stacks of cash. Fucking assholes. So next time you complain about your precious little fucking Smash 4 main, just be glad I put the bitch in the game for you in the first place. And if I had a microphone, here is the part where I would drop it, and then walk away to the sound of your roaring applause.
This game should have never been patched.
You fucking motherfucker.
And there you have it, guys. That is the conclusion to Character Main Stereotypes. Thank you so much for watching this series. I cannot even believe the amount of fucking support that this series got, man. At the time of me saying this, all of these episodes have gotten like a combined 500,000 views. And that is more than I would have ever have imagined this series getting. And thank you so fucking much for 30,000 subscribers. I can't even believe that that number is next to my name when I look at my channel. It's just mind-boggling. But yeah, guys, if you want to put the icing on the cake, please consider giving this video a like or leaving me a comment. Remember to not take any of these videos serious at all. I mean, this is just a joke. And I will see you all in the next video. Deuces. I swear to God, if introspective says one more fucking thing about my... Oh, wait. The series is over? Oh. Well, then I guess I should, like, just continue on with my life, or whatever. Okay, bye!